Good morning, everyone. I went outside to grab my water bottle, and then when I came back in from the outside air, it smelled so good in here. So I hope you're enjoying your brunch. Our first selection is called Bach Arioso, and it comes from a cantata by Johann Sebastian Bach. He was a Protestant in the Lutheran Church, which predates the Methodist Church by a couple hundred years, but is very much in the Protestant tradition you're familiar with. But I just thought it might be nice for you to have a tiny bit of background about what a cantata was, since this is from a cantata. So a typical church service in Bach's time would begin about 7 a.m. and continue for 3 or 4 hours. During this time, there would be 2 complete cantatas, which are sacred stories from the Word of God, from the Bible, but they're sung. And so there would be 2 complete cantatas, and there would be communion, which would last about an hour, and it had a lot of music, and there was, of course, a sermon. And so perhaps the ministers of Bach's time could take something from your wonderful minister who just knows how to get right to it. And it was a lovely sermon. So this melody is from that cantata, and it's been arranged for cello and piano.
Thank you. And so now I've got a tune that you've heard a couple of times previously. I did it for a prelude early on while I started working here, but I'm bringing it back. It's the Liszt Etude number 3. It is in D flat major, and it's been called un sospiro, which means a sigh in Italian. And it's been proclaimed by many people as one of the most beautiful works Liszt ever wrote. A lot of music educators disagree on that point, but you know, take it for what you will. This is Liszt's Un Sospiro.
Thank you.
It'd be fine with me if he'd played that every day for me. So while he rests his hands a few minutes, I'm going to play a piece by also by Bach, what we started with. And this piece is it's meant to be for solo cello. And so instead of just playing the melody, the tune part that you might hum, if you're remembering it, this has the melody and the harmony, like he does with the piano, except it's a little harder on the cello. So you'll hear me play some notes that kind of sound like a guitar chord might be if it was strummed, but I'll be bowing it. So there's a couple different moods in here. It starts out with a sarabande, which is slow, and then a minuet, and a bourée. And these are all dances, but this wasn't written really to be danced to. But I don't know if people have eaten burritos to it before, but I think it works. So.
Thank you. I
Next, we have a short piece together by Robert Schumann, a Romantic era composer. And in your program, it says Traumerei, and in German, that means dreaming. And to me, this one feels a little bit like a lullaby. So enjoy it, please. So much. So this next work is a collaboration of sorts. The original tune is attributed to Michael Praetorius, who was writing music in the early part of the Reformation. And we think that this is a Christmas carol dating to the early 1600s. And I looked in your Methodist hymnal and it's there. So it has it has been a popular carol for a long time in the sacred sense of the word. So, lo and behold, in the late 1970s, early 1980s, a man named Mark Sommer thought about this and decided this would be a beautiful hymn to set for a solo piece for cello. And he happens to be a jazz musician. So I guess we're kind of getting into the more modern part of the concert. And so not only are there some things that feel a little bit jazzy about this, You'll also see some techniques that you might see guitarists normally do. So the cello kind of gets to go crazy for this one. So I hope you like "Lo, How a Rose Ere Blooming."
Liz is, without a doubt, the best cellist that I know. She's phenomenal. And it is so cool to have a soon-to-be mother-in-law who can just sit down and play the cello like that. I'm so happy. What was I going to say? The next, we've got a couple of sets that we actually worked up over the course of the pandemic. So I moved here into New Mexico right when the pandemic began, and so we started just working up some music so that we could just perform some fun sets for people if we ever got the chance to perform live again. And so without further ado, we've got the Snowman Suite, three movements of that, and then a couple of tangos, which she introduced me to the whole concept of tangos. So try not to clap between the movements of each set, but, you know, whatever happens, happens. Thank you.
Well, I'm all for that because in my other life, I'm a ski patroller at Sandia Peak. So I just wanted to say that Clay has been very eager to learn about more Latino culture. We have a lot more here than they do in northern Michigan. And he loves the chilies, and he loves the diversity of New Mexico. And so he's learning how to play some of the more Latino-type music, too. So we've had a little bit of fun. Of course, the tango comes from Argentina, and it's a wonderful dance form. And these have been arranged for us. Normally, a band would be up here with maybe a couple violins, a piano, and maybe a bandoneon, which some of you may know is a small accordion. So I guess if you squint a little bit, maybe we can seem like that. But these are a pair. We play them together, and we'll just play them straight through. Thank you. Thank you so much. Before Clay introduces his last piece, I would like to thank you so much for making me feel so welcome as a visitor this morning. I really enjoyed my morning here. And thank you so much for asking us to play, because I hope you had half as much fun as we have had.
Okay, last one. I don't believe any of you have heard this entire piece by me. It's Chopin's Scherzo number 1 in B minor. Scherzo means joke, but this is a very dark and serious piece. And I guess Chopin just missed the whole boat on the whole joke thing, I guess. But there is this gorgeous middle section. There are three full sections that you'll be able to recognize, but the gorgeous middle section is actually a Polish hymn that I can't pronounce the name of, but it means lullaby, and it's a lullaby for Jesus. And so as you listen to that, just think about, you know, peaceful thoughts, and then we'll see how the piece ends up and rounds out.
Thank you.
Thank you so much. That was so much fun for me. I really appreciate it. So thanks for coming to Liz and for inviting us. Kara, I think it was, that organized all of this. That was amazing. So thanks for coming. Woo!
One last time.